Ladies and gents, today's video is on how to get rid of bladder urgency. And no, you don't have to buy a snake oil, line up for a miracle drug, or discreetly do Kegel exercises while lining up at a Walmart. A few years back, I made an interesting discovery about how to get rid of bladder urgency with a diet, and you want to hear about it. Hi, I'm Dorothea Damiak, former board-certified naturopathic doctor, author of 5 books, and the creator of Youth in Proportions Blueprints, so you can finally get an A in health. First, a little bit of clarification. I don't have symptoms, I don't have diseases, I don't take prescription drugs, and I seldom take supplements. But a few years back, I started to have nighttime bladder urgency. Initially, I didn't think much about it, as many symptoms simply come and go. But when I kept on waking up consistently for a week or two, I started to seriously think how to get rid of the bladder urgency. Having to pee at night is not a sign of good health. I know. Just like you, I saw commercials saying that bladder frequency and nighttime urgency is normal part of aging. It's not. And no, you don't have to have symptoms of poor health just because you're getting older. Let me clarify things. If you have bladder urgency, there is a reason for it. And no, it's not age. Something else is at play. Also, be aware that taking a pill for an overactive bladder does not improve bladder health. It just suppresses the symptoms, so you can live with a sick bladder without having to think about it. But let's get back to my bladder. I fixed it accidentally while performing my periodic dietary experiments. After my retirement, I traveled extensively with my husband in a FedEx van, which he converted into a motorhome. Limited kitchen facilities make cooking rather challenging. Because of the difficulties, we decided to dramatically simplify our meals. This was exactly at the time when my bladder was acting up. So due to logistical limitations, we went on a serious elimination diet where we used only a few basic ingredients to prepare our meals. This is when weird things started to happen. My bladder suddenly got super overactive, as if it didn't like the way I was eating. Bladder frequency was through the roof during the day as well as at night. I had to keep close to the bathroom. Many people wouldn't think much about linking dietary changes to bladder frequency and would reach for a pill to feel more comfortable. But that's not what was on my mind. I wanted my healthy bladder back. I didn't want to patch a solvable problem with a drug. Taking a pill in order not to feel symptoms is not healthcare. That's disease management. One day, while I was on limited diet, a strange thing happened. When I went to the bathroom, I made a shocking discovery. I was being sand. And no, not just a grain or two, I mean a whole beach. Fast forward, it turned out that sand wasn't sand at all, but it was calcium oxalate crystals that my body was massively getting rid of. Yeah, but why? And why now? So this is what happened. When I reduced my food to a few ingredients, by chance, I eliminated all sources of oxalates in my diet, including beans, sweet potatoes, almonds, and chocolate. If you didn't know what oxalates and oxalic acid is, here's a quick explanation. Oxalic acid is a sharp and corrosive molecule that occurs naturally in many plants. It binds to various minerals, including calcium, and forms crystals such as calcium oxalate. Calcium oxalate can not only harden the tissue and make them inelastic, but the crystals can accumulate in various tissues, causing irritation, inflammation, and malfunction of organs. Oxalate crystals is not something the body wants to hold on to, but if the diet contains lots of oxalates, the body might not have much choice. Only when oxalate intake gets close to zero, the body might try to eliminate oxalate residue from the tissue. So my oxalate-free diet by chance turned out to be a powerful catalyst to dump oxalates stored in my body. This is exactly what fixed my bladder urgency. Now, a word of caution. Oxalate accumulation is a long and quiet process, and many victims are completely unaware of it. Healthcare professionals are seldom aware that oxalate can lead to anything else than kidney stones. So don't be surprised that your doctor insists that your bladder, joints, or heart have nothing to do with oxalates. He simply doesn't know. Your doctor may have zero awareness that there is a link between oxalates and bladder urgency. Because of that, he may be guessing that your bladder malfunction is due to too much water, advanced age, menopause, caffeine, prostate, or other reasons. But unless you do yourself a favor and go on oxalate-free diet, you won't know if your bladder suffers from oxalate accumulation. Well, oxalate accumulation might not only cause bladder problems. The crystals can lead to other common health problems such as arthritis, constipation, arrhythmia, chronic ulcers, etc. So was the case with my body, but long story short, my bladder is back to its youthful days. It's fully functional, has no symptoms, and can accommodate huge amount of liquid. No more nighttime waking or searching for bathroom while in town. None of that, and get this, no pills, no snake oils, no draining of the bank account for diagnostic tests or medical procedures. Health is wonderful, don't you think? Here's another surprise. One more symptom completely disappeared with the new diet. Body stiffness. My knees and shoulders regain a full range of motion without any rehab or acupuncture. And all my chronic injuries miraculously healed as if they were never there. Why is it a big deal? Because body stiffness and the dreaded cardiovascular disease are linked. Some studies indicate that body inflexibility may be an early indicator of arterial stiffness. In other words, stiff body and cardiovascular disease may go together. So chances are, if you go on the oxalate-free diet, you may not only get rid of the bladder urgency, but also lower your cardiovascular risk. So how do you go about oxalate-free diet? First, you need to know which foods contain oxalates. Among those are beans, almond, spinach, sweet potatoes, berries, nuts, soybeans, tea, and wheat bran. Yep. You may think that your plant-rich diet is super healthy, yet be completely puzzled by a bladder from hell. Now, at least you have a suspect. Oxalate-rich foods. Once you have a list of what to avoid, you may want to purge your diet from those. When you decide to be oxalate-free, be consistent. Stick with it for a few months. The process is slow and goes in waves. Expect an aggressive detoxification bout at the beginning and a number of less severe detox waves later on. However, the process does not start the minute you change the diet. It might take a week or two before the body mobilizes the stores, so observe and be patient. Here's a warning for some of you. If you suspect that your body is loaded with oxalate crystals, you may want to take things slow. Sudden removal of dietary oxalates may lead to an abrupt release of crystals, leading to super strong aggravation of symptoms. Don't be surprised with suddenly appearing pain, spasticity, inflammation, or irritation in various parts of the body. These might feel scary, so go slow if you need to. I myself started to see aggravation of symptoms in the first month, which was followed by a short burst of amelioration. After a few weeks, these short bursts of calm bladder became longer and eventually gave rise to a permanent state of well-being. So be consistent and stay body aware. If it helps you, keep a daily journal. Also, if you suspect high oxalate accumulation, please refrain from the following. Taking mega doses of vitamin C. Vitamin C can convert to oxalate, especially if your dose exceeds 1 gram. Also, avoid taking cranberry juice to calm down the bladder. It is a common recommendation for a suspected bladder infection. However, cranberry concentrates have a high oxalate content and may make things worse. Instead, do the following. Make sure you aren't vitamin B6 deficient. If in doubt, take 100 or 200 milligrams a day. Vitamin B6 deficiency leads to lower oxalate excretion and its higher retention. Additionally, increase water intake to facilitate oxalate flushing. And now it's the time for the end of the video bonus. Here's a list of symptoms that you may resolve on an oxalate-free diet. I will leave you with that and see you in the next video.